The fundamentals behind the physical examination of the knee joint should be seen as surface anatomy. Okay? When you are seeing the most anterior aspect, the very prominent patella. So mark the patella first. And after that, tibial tubercle, tibial tuberosity. Okay? And then distal femur, medial epicondyle. Okay? And then laterally, when you touch the prominence, lateral epicondyle. In the tibia, laterally, Guardian's tubercle. Okay? And then from the posterior aspect, when I am touching, that is the end of the fibula. Okay? Laterally. So, head of the fibula, Guardian's tubercle, lateral epicondyle, tibial tubercle, patella, base, apex, and then you have the medial epicondyle. Okay? This is the medial condyle of the tibia. In that, there is a ridge-like portion where the pes anserine tendon, okay, that gets attached. Okay, you can see the muscles. And then medial side, little more higher, the margin of the femur. Okay, when you are running along the thigh, first block, that is the adductor tubercle. Okay, so adductor tubercle, medial epicondyle, patella is obvious, tibial tubercle. Pes anserine, like a crest like, okay, ridge. Guardian's tubercle, head of the fibula, okay, lateral epicondyle, okay. All these are bony landmarks. And then next, you come to the structures. Above the patella, okay, so above, superiorly to the patella, is the quadriceps tendon. Whereas below the patella is the ligamentum patellae. Okay? Ligamentum patellae is otherwise called as patellar tendon. This is quadriceps tendon, this is patellar tendon. And then Guardian's tubercle, you have iliotibial band. Okay? You can see the iliotibial band. Okay? Here in my hand, this is biceps femoris. This is iliotibial band. Okay? If I am resisting abduction, asking him to push outside, push the iliotibial band, I can palpate. Okay? And if I am resisting flexion, the biceps femoris, I can palpate. Okay? That. So medial side, the pes anserine tendon, I have shown earlier, that is three muscles. Okay, three muscles are attaching here. One is the sartorius, okay, which is coming like obliquely from the anterior superior iliac spine. Next one is semitendinosus, part of the medial hamstring. Next is the gracilis. Gracilis is part of the long adductors. Semitendinosus is part of the hamstring. Sartorius is part of the flexors of the hip. Abbreviated like STG. STG. Semitendinosus. Semi sartorius. Semitendinosus. Tendinosus. So T. Okay. And the gracilis. Okay. That constitutes the pes anserine tendon. And beneath the tendon, pes anserine bursa is there. Okay. And here again, we have a very thin bursa here above the patella, which is called as the prepatellar bursa. Then here, we have two bursae. One is deep infrapatellar bursa, between the patellar tendon and the tibia. Superficial infrapatellar bursa, that is between the ligamentum patellae and the skin. Okay? Suprapatellar bursa, above the femur, and beneath the quadriceps tendon. Okay? So suprapatellar bursa, infrapatellar is superficial and deep, prepatellar bursa. Okay, bursa are filled with synovial fluid. Pes anserine bursa. So these are all the bursa. Clear? In the muscles, quadriceps, four heads, quadriceps. Rectus femoris from the ASIS, below the ASIS. And then vastus intermedius is just below the rectus femoris. Vastus medialis, it comes here to the medial border of the patella. And vastus lateralis inserted to the lateral border of the patella. And then hamstrings, lateral hamstring is biceps, medial hamstring is semimembranosus and semitendinosus. Okay. So here semimembranosus first. Okay. Semitendinosus, the more rope-like or stick-like. Okay. Thin. That is semitendinosus. And after that, the gastrocnemius muscle has medial head and lateral head. They originate from distal femur. So they are also flexors of the knee. Deeper to the gastrocnemius. Okay. Deeper to the gastrocnemius, we have like this obliquely directed popliteus. Okay, in the popliteal fossa. It attaches from the lateral condyle of the femur to the medial condyle of the tibia posteriorly. The popliteus is known as the unlocking muscle. It internally rotates the tibia so that it will flex. Okay? Unlocking is flexion. Locking is extension. Okay, of the knee. We come to the biomechanics. And the next one, ligaments. Most important one. Other than the ligaments are better there. First and foremost, medial epicondyle to the medial epicondyle. Tibia also has a medial epicondyle. Femur has a medial epicondyle. Okay. So both this connected. Okay. Connected. If you run the fingers perpendicular. Okay. Medial collateral ligament. Then same way, head of the fibula to lateral epicondyle. Okay. That is the lateral collateral ligament. Okay. And then when you flex the knee, you will find a hollow both the sides of the patellar tendon. Okay. Just to project that medially and also laterally. Okay. So when you are flexing to 70 or 90 degrees, you can find both the sides the line will be continuing. Okay, so that side and this side. Okay, that is the joint line. So medial joint line, lateral joint line. Okay. Approximately, you will also palpate the medial meniscus also there, and here the lateral meniscus between the femur and the tibia. Specifically, if you want to palpate the medial meniscus, other position is the figure of four, and then here you can palpate the medial meniscus. Okay, in the top. Okay, so that's the characteristic position. Next, other ligaments, all of them are deeper. Anterior cruciate ligament, the direction is like this. It comes between the condyles. Okay, directed anteriorly. Posterior cruciate, directed from the femur posteriorly towards the intercondylar region. Besides the posterior cruciate, medially and laterally. Laterally is the oblique popliteal ligament and arcuate popliteal ligament. Medially, ligament of Humphrey and ligament of Lisburg. All four are accompanying the posterior cruciate ligaments. Okay. And then meniscus is there. Meniscus is attached to the femur by meniscofemoral ligaments. Meniscus is attached to tibia by meniscotibial ligaments. Meniscus is attached to patella by meniscopatellar ligaments, medial and also lateral. After that, patella has another deep fascia, fibrous expansion, both the sides. Okay. That is the medial retinaculum and the lateral retinaculum. Okay. You can distinguish the retinaculum when you push the patella medially. Push the patella medially, the fibrous structure of the lateral retinaculum will be palpable. Okay. So you push it medial, then you palpate the lateral retinaculum. You push it lateral, then you palpate the medial retinaculum. Okay. Because when you are pushing it laterally, the medial retinaculum will be stretched. When it is stretched, it will be palpable. Inflamed, the injury is there, easily it will be palpable. Normal, it is not that easily palpable. Okay? All these bursas and tendons will get swollen, they will be thickened during the bursitis or the tendinitis. So, palpation is a very important part of the knee injuries, especially sports injuries, more common in the knee. So, evaluation is done on the field by mainly by palpation. Okay? So, you know the surface markings, then better you can identify the injuries of the knee. So, anatomy is translated into surface anatomy in physical examination of the knee complex. Posteriorly, the nerve, most important is sciatic nerve comes, popliteal fossa, just 2 inches above the popliteal fossa itself. Okay, it divides into common peroneal. Okay, this is biceps femoris. Okay, this is common peroneal. If you trace it, that one, it will come to the head of the fibula. Okay, and then if you are focusing on the head of the fibula, okay, you are actually testing for the common peroneal nerve. Because it winds around the neck of the fibula and then it comes down. Afterwards it is the leg. Okay. It has deep peroneal and superficial peroneal branches. Superficial peroneal supplies the peroneus longus and peroneus brevis. Deep peroneal supplies the extensor hallucis longus, extensor digitorum longus and peroneus tertius. Okay. Dorsiflexors of the ankle and tibial anterior. Okay. All are supplied by deep peroneal. So, medial side, the same division of the sciatic, okay, 5 centimeters above, comes medial, okay, and after that, if you come closer medial side, okay, from here, within the calf, see the direction of palpation, okay, and the elastic thread-like structure which you can palpate. I can draw it in the till the tarsal tunnel, okay, which is there medially, that is the tibial nerve. Okay, so nerves are also palpable. Initially you can do this tunnel sign, later once the numbness is coming, you palpate with the fingers. Okay, you will get that nerve underneath your fingers. Okay, so that's about the anatomy, surface anatomy in physical examination for the knee.